goddamn cockroaches! I got this girl, Henrietta. Shacks up at the Carousel Hotel in the Hollow. Smart as a fucking whip. I left a fucking bag with her. Should have all I need to get by.
Two tears in a bucket.
So, yeah, me and Sammy back in the day, we had these two knockouts. And we was drinking, partying, having the time of our lives. This was 1942. No, 43. He must have been about the age you are now. And the girl with your old man, she starts getting into the making out. But she got a problem. Sammy's passed out cold. Told you he was drunk off his ass. But this girl was into him, so she gives him the benefit of the doubt. Keeps trying. Smacks him a bit. Wakes him up. But I think I just messed myself. Now, where the fuck was I? Oh, yeah. And the girl with your old man, she starts getting into the making out, but she got a problem. Sammy's passed out cold. Told you he was drunk off his ass. But this girl was into him, so she gives him the benefit of the doubt. Keeps trying. Smacks him a bit, wakes him up. But every time she starts getting into it, Sammy drops. Poor bastard couldn't stay awake to save his fucking life. Finally, she's had enough and storms out of there, cursing the goddamn Blue Street. And do you know who that woman was?
Herla.
Jesus Christ, man. Herla didn't move to New Bordeaux until 44. I'll show you who it was. I got the photo right here.
Are you kidding me? Sammy had a shot with her.
She was passing through on her way to Hollywood. This is good right here. Sorry again about what happened to Sammy and Ellis.
Appreciate it.
Motherfucker, you look like the cat who ate the canary.
This here's our first step toward breaking Marcano and taking over the city. I hear what y'all got to say, but I decide who gets the turf. And in the end, my decision is final.
Your decision? Listen here. You put my men on the front line and locking down the action, I consider your decision fucking made. Ain't nothing to discuss.
From where I'm sitting, it looks like you already got a plan for this part of the city.
I think what my two friends here are trying to say is calling in help to lock down rackets sets a certain level of expectation. You might want to keep that in mind next time, kid. We got a lot of fragile egos here.
You trusted me this far, Lankin?
There's only one smart play here, partner.
We got a long road ahead of us. Don't make the wrong first step, lad.
You know I can handle this.
We talk about making money, but what it comes down to is respect.
Calling this one for Skeletta.
About fucking time. Always knew you had a good head on your shoulders.
You got a funny goddamn definition of loyalty. Maybe I'll keep that in mind next time you come calling, asking for help.
As for me, I'll be biding my time and waiting for one of you assholes to fuck up. Fair warning.
We're done for now. You'll hear from me if I need you.
Yeah, that's what I thought. What a prick.
Turns out you were right.
I gotta go. Thank you for this.
Happy hunting, Donovan.
Miss Lancaster's helping me with a side project. You get a name at Enzo?
Yeah, Remy Duval. He's not only building the casino, he also owns all the land where it's being built.
Remy Duval? The jackass on the radio?
His family's been down here a couple hundred years. Thinks it makes him everyone's massa.
According to this, he heads up the Southern Union in his spare time.
The Southern Union's basically the fucking Klan. Right before I shipped out, Father James was with some other folks protesting the fact that the city didn't have any black cops. Southern Union came in and kicked the shit out of everybody they could get their hands on. Day after, they spray-painted "God hates niggers" across the front of his church.
If President Andrew Johnson had actually executed those traitorous fucks, we wouldn't have this goddamn problem.
Enzo also mentioned Olivia Marcano.
Olivia's an outlier. Old Southern money. She's the one that was married to Sal's brother, Lucho. At least until someone slit his throat.
And she runs Frisco Fields.
Ever since Lucho died. She expanded his drug business and opened a PCP lab. And since a lot of mafiosos live up there, she probably just has a place they can socialize.
Well, it's usually in the back of some business.
I never knew the mob had women as capos.
She's there to keep Duval in line. Only people these entitled pricks listen to are other entitled pricks.
So who are you gonna go after first?
Duval. Since he owns the land where the casino's being built, killing him will muddy things up.
You think hitting Olivia's businesses will help draw him out?
I've known racist assholes like him my entire life. Black man like me running around terrorizing white folks. He ain't gonna be able to let that stand. His pride will bring him down.
You know, that bourbon's not cheap. Good luck out there.
Sun Show with Remy Duval. He had a guest on there y'all are familiar with. Chief Wilson. Poor old Chief Wilson. He's the man time forgot. The man death forgot to put out of his goddamn misery. An old worthless motherfucker who spends his days beating on colored folk and his nights beating on himself, if you catch my drift. When he was asked if New Bordeaux has a colored problem, Chief Wilson had this to say. What we've got is a black power problem. He also threw out some interesting numbers. Seeing 20% of the city's population is black, but 60% of the prison population is black. Now, what he failed to mention is that 100% of his law officers are white. So it would seem to me that what New Bordeaux has is a police power problem. Chief Wilson showed himself to be the definition of ignorance. He is a man, a white man in a position of great power. He's literally got the ability to shoot and kill anyone he deems dangerous. Think about that. The same man expressing thoughts like this. You go back all the way to after the war between the states. We had a whole mess of them. That would be us black folk, if you're unsure. We had a whole mess of them. Free down here, and next thing you know, they're trying to take over the government. Ain't got a cent to their names or shoes to walk in, and want to be in Congress. And that's coming from a man who could be pulling you over for a busted taillight. Oh, God forbid, speeding. Does this sound like a man whose primary interest is protecting everyone in the city? Or does it sound like someone more interested in protecting a way of thinking, centered around keeping us black folk in line, making sure we don't get too uppity? But Chief Wilson, I got some bad news for you. We uppity niggas are just getting started. Now here's a larger issue at hand. The big picture, so to speak. Chief Wilson sets the tone, pays for an entire police department. And at his disposal, it's an entire police department made up of white officers. Now why do you think the city's seeing a record number of police beats? And why do you think we've had twice as many police shootings involving young black men this year in the land? Is it because crime is running rampant? Or is it because our police department has a shoot first, ask questions, made a policy? Who needs Miranda when you got Meg? Chief Wilson, enlisted. This is the part of the show where I warn you. When the holler speaks, you better listen.
Salutations and all that shite.
Long way from Point Verdun, aren't you, Bear?
Decided it was time to branch out. Not really a lot for me in that organization anymore.
So what's your new line?
Mind-melting narcotics. And I hear the best are coming out of Frisco. PCP. And it's cutting into my business.
Okay. So where's the operation?
Beats the hell out of me. But a while back, Miss Olivia Marcano hired a top-notch chemist named Bobby Bastian. Tasked him with upgrading her operations, which will make it impossible for the small-time cooks to compete. Hell, they even got taxis delivering their shit.
If I can get to Bastion's dealers, maybe they'll give him up. Tell me something I can use against him.
That ain't all. Word is Miss Marcano brought in a couple other eggheads from San Francisco. Get rid of them, and Bobby Bastion's gonna find himself nice and fucked. Put a beating on some of Bastion's guys, and maybe they'll tell you something useful.
Thank you. I'm just tired, man.
Another shopping trip for the lab.
Gasoline this time. This shit has put it in your car, fucking gas in it. The people. Cover!
I'm fucking stuck!
Get him off my back, goddammit!
You better tell me what Bobby Bastion's up to.
We've been moving the speed around town using taxis. Last I heard, the boss was keeping the cash drops at the dispatch garage.
Can't trust a rat.
Hey, bruh, you hear that?
That was fucking brutal.
Out of the way.
Thank you.
Hey, Brooke, you hear that?
Think we might have company.
Not stop until I find you, boy. Somebody help.
Why does he have a gun?
Emma!
You boys see what I see?
Hunker down!
Hey, bro, you hear that?
Could have swore I heard something.
is your day to die. Gonna geld you, motherfucker.
BYU 620.
Inside. When you come back,
I think you're looking for me?
Jackie, a mutual friend sent me.
I figured Johnny was lying when he said he had a friend. The Cloak and Dagger Act's a bit much, though.
You know Donovan?
You could say that. I'm a special agent with Treasury.
The IRS is looking into Olivia Marcano? Pretty sure she's smart enough to pay her taxes.
I'm investigating a man who works for her, Chester Moreau. From what I've been able to piece together, he finances the Southern Union.
Figured those racist fucks had factored into this somehow. Man I'm after, Remy Duval, is a grand poopah or some shit.
Whatever the connection, it's deep, it's secret, and it's bringing in a lot of money. Much more than you'd expect from a territory like Frisco Fields. The Bureau looked into it for a while, but no one's talking.
Trust me, I get my hands on one of those bastards, he's talking.
I thought as much. Only other lead I have is that the Southern Union's got stashes of propaganda scattered around the neighborhood. Might not seem like much, but you hit those, you'll get the attention of the people who matter.
Yeah. Rose starts losing money, he's gonna want to know why. I'll be back once I have something actionable.
No one's really talking around here. I think you're gonna have to get to Chester's people directly.
About the bullshit in sheep's clothing. The one staring right back at us. That's right. We talking about the briar patch. Those of us living here in the Hollow dealt with this kind of thing before. Something that we were told was for us, for our family. Yeah. Some of our very own relatives put blood, sweat, and tears into building the goddamn thing. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That place out yonder we'd all prefer to forget. Ben, Saturday's fun park. Now, I'll admit right now that this crazy game is still one of the best goddamn roller coasters I've ever been on, for truth. But everything about how that park was put together should offend any sensible person, black or otherwise. From...
What the hell was that?
Now, almost as long as Chester's. Gotta protect our heritage.
Better make sure this is okay. Hey.
I know I heard something.
Lord God.
Somebody call the cops!
Bingo, bitch! Fuck!
Ain't neither of us walking out of here.
How's Chester Moreau make his money?
Mr. Moreau's got some of our other Southern Union guys on a job for him. A big one. Secret.
Can't have you talking.
it going. How's it going?
Suppose I gotta check that out.
Come on now, Snowflake. Where you think you're going?
Fuck you!
Who are you?
There is no rest for
I got him!
Wicked.
I got him!
Get down low!
All units, search is called off. Repeat, abandoned search. Return to patrol.
Shit, where is he?
I think that asshole's still around.
There we go! I got this!
Damn.
Take cover!
Gotta beat him! I got this!
United States Marines invade the southern half of the DMZ in Vietnam to block an expected offensive by the North Vietnamese Army yesterday. 168 enemy soldiers were reported killed.
Hands on the dashboard, motherfucker.
Who the hell are you?
How's Chester Moreau make his money?
Order a couple cold ones at your
local... Oh, Jesus!
Or pick up a six-pack at your favorite store. Stoltz. Cold, mellow refreshment that's good to the last golden drop.
Stoltz. Stop the car! Stop the car!
Spill, let's go!
Look at me! Who the fuck's gonna tell me anything?
You trying to piss me off?
My folks dropped me on my head. I don't remember shit.
Your time's
got your bell-ass supermarket. There's something going on there after hours. Whatever it is, Mr. Moreau's trying to keep it here quiet.
The Royal Hotel.
Sorry-ass motherfucker.
Book one of our romantic weekend getaways and enjoy a bottle of champagne and complimentary candle to help set the perfect mood for a night of cuddles and bubbles. Enjoy a fine meal at our four-star restaurant. Dance the night away to the big band sounds of the Eddie Fowler Orchestra. The Royal Hotel, where the views will literally take your breath away. Located in beautiful downtown New Boston. Halton's has super duper savings that will keep...
All units, search is called off. Repeat, abandoned search. Return to patrol.
What do you need? Did you learn anything?
Hit those bastards pretty hard and all I got was a single word. Bel Air.
You know something? That tracks. Moreau is the majority owner of Bel Air Supermarket. As soon as you started hitting those racist assholes, the phones lit up. No one mentioned the Bel Air by name, but I did get a time, 10 p.m., and enough circumstantial evidence to tie it all together. Whatever's going on, it's happening at that supermarket tonight.
I'll look into it.
Lincoln, listen. The thing some of those guys were hinting at, it's bad. Real bad. So go in quiet. We need to find out exactly what Moreau is up to, and we won't get another chance.
You got it, Jackie.
The only one who could ever reach me was the son of a...
reported in Frisco Field. Suspect is described as a colored male. All units, please respond immediately.
Kids for a day or two, anything more than that, and I'm gonna give the little suckers away. I'm not gonna lie and tell my kid I didn't get stoned when I was her age.
Howdy, friend.
Think you'll make it to Gates?
Maybe. They're just getting started upstairs.
It has to...
Huh?
On behalf of Mr. Moreau, Mr. Marcano, and the Southern Union, thank you for coming out tonight. Mr. Moreau has asked me to remind you that we're only accepting cash. Again, this is a fine specimen. No visible injuries or scars, and examined personally by Mr. Moreau's doctors.
Please, just let me go.
We'll start the bidding at $1,000. Do I hear 1,000? 1,000. Do I hear 2,000? 2,000.
You can't do this.
3,000 to the man in front. 3,000.
Bingo, bitch!
I'm right! I'm hurt over here!
God damn!
I need help!
The light
fire! Where are the others?
Chester's got them niggas around Frisco! Just make it fucking quick! Dig, motherfucker!
We're done here.